So the next will be our lifetime achievement award for Mr. for Dr. Rajaram. I request our president, Dr. Subramaniam, to take over the
Can you
presentation.
just see whether Dr. Rajaram is has logged in?
Let me see, sir.
I am Dr. Rajaram here. Can you hear me?
Fantastic, sir. Yeah, we are able to see you.
Okay.
Rajaram Nagaratnam.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you very much.
I request our president to take over the proceedings, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Sandeep. And thank you very much for putting up the Lifetime Achievement Award to be given to Dr. Rajaram. Can you zoom this a little bit? Okay, that's all right. It is my pleasure, sir, that to invite Dr. Rajaram for this Lifetime Achievement Award. I am reading out the plaque. Lifetime Achievement Award, on this date of 28th February 2021, the citation is awarded to Dr. N. Rajaram for his outstanding contribution to society in the field of medicine. An alumnus of Madras Medical College, he was awarded MBBS in 1978, MS DLO in 1981. He retired as professor of ENT. Dr. Jyoti, I have been muting you. You've been unmuting yourself. Okay. Sorry for the interruption. He retired as professor of ENT. He is presently a consultant at Venkateswara Hospital, Nandanam, Chennai, and Bharatiraja Hospital, Chennai. He has attended many national conferences and workshops. He has published several papers and received many awards, among which he received was the Johnson Medal for the best paper presentation.
Can you, Dr. Jyoti, can you unmute yourself?
I have muted her. She apparently has a child which keeps unmuting. If this continues, I will have to remove her from the list of participants. I don't want to do that. Dr. Rajaram is a life member of IMA Chennai Kodambakkam branch and ex-president of AOI Chennai. We, the president and members of the Indian Medical Association Chennai Kodambakkam branch, feel proud to honor a doyen in the medical field. Dr. Rajaram, would you like to say a few words, please? Your journey through life as a professional and otherwise.
First of all, thank you, everybody. I should first thank the IMA Kodambakkam for honoring me with this award. Thank you very much. As far as the lecture is concerned, I don't think I'm going to go into that. I would rather go into one day of my life, the best day of my life, which was somewhere in 1994, when I was in Saudi Arabia, and I was the head of the Department of ENT. And under me, I had a Lebanese, Egyptians, Pakistanis, and the very first day was a very nervous day for me because I had to deal with all these multinationals and I had to make a good impression. I'm telling you this because this is a good session to let everybody know that we Indian doctors are really good. And to know that, you need to go there to really know how good you are. Now, let me start my story. Three incidences happened on that day which brought me to a good recognition in the hospital and in the country. Number one, when I was doing ward rounds, the very first day, we saw a patient. My Egyptian assistant had done a tonsillectomy 1 year back, but subsequently, the patient was admitted 4-5 times for bleeding from the mouth. This was spurious bleeding. Nobody could make out what it was. And the hospital was in a very embarrassed state. How are we going to make him all right? So I went there, I saw the patient, and then I asked her to open the mouth. He refused. He said, I would be treated only by the Egyptian doctor. And she looked at him, and I looked at the Egyptian doctor. I found that he was very handsome, and he was very nervous as well. I got the hunch. I knew what the diagnosis was, and I only hoped it was correct. So I told the Egyptian doctor, please examine her. And she was very eager. She opened her mouth wide open. And at that time, I picked up the pillow and found under the pillow a long needle with a little blood clot at the tip. It surprised everybody. And then I said, I told the patient, you are married. Should I show this needle to your husband? And that was the last we saw of her. What actually happened was, she took the needle, poked herself as and when she wanted to beat her boyfriend, the Egyptian. Got a little blood, came and got admitted. For 3 days, she would have a good time. Not that the Egyptian knew this, but they used to have, they talked with each other. And that was a spurious bleeding. No amount of hematology test could reveal the thing. So this was my first success. The second one was, that same afternoon, we had a call from the ICU, pediatric ICU. There was a child with a tracheostomy. Somebody had put a suction inside and suddenly found that the catheter had gone inside the trachea. So they called me and I went there along with my team. I looked at the child. The child was normal, absolutely normal. And was wondering why everybody was so apprehensive. So I told the doctor, do you honestly think that catheter would have gone inside the trachea? There would be bronchospasm. Child would probably be dead, or at least there would be a serious stridor. And she said, I don't know, sir, but the catheter has gone inside. I'm sure of that. So I said, instead of taking the patient to the theater to do a bronchoscopy and remove whatever it is, why don't you look into the suction apparatus? So we went to the suction apparatus, opened, and then we found the catheter there. Now what had happened is, the suction had suctioned this catheter and taken it inside the machine. To my surprise, when I saw the thing, it was a very, you know, they were trying to put the suction inside the catheter inside the suction, and the whole thing got sucked in. Anyway, that gave me a good name. The third, of course, the same day, I did a bronchoscopy in a child with an inspiratory stridor, and that was the first ever case in that hospital. It was a major hospital. First successful case. And subsequently, we went on to do a lot of bronchoscopy cases. And we became a center for bronchoscopy, esophagoscopy. I'm very happy to say that I taught all my multinationals how to do a bronchoscopy. And to this day, that happens to be the major center. A place called King Khalid Hospital in Najran. This is my lesson. I just want everybody to know that I'm very grateful to our country, our teachers, professors, my college, and most important of all, the patients who gave me an opportunity to follow this wonderful profession. And I would like to say that when during my stay in Saudi, there was always a background hum of everybody saying, Indian doctors are good. Indian doctors are good, and Indian doctors are good. Thank you very much. Thank you again, IMA, for giving me this chance. My talk is over.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. We are honored to honor you.
Thank you.
Such an experience.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing and your experience and your expertise with us. Hope to see you in much, much bigger positions in future, sir.
I am already 70. I don't have much to go.
There, our life begins after only 60, sir.
Wish you a very long life and long association with us again, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Very nice.
Share your dreams. You can share your experience.
Wonderful. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you. Congratulations and thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.